Morning. That's right. For the third winter in a row, we're under the influence of the La Niña climate pattern. If you remember, this is a pattern that happens in the Pacific Ocean where cooler than normal water is upwelled, and it sets off this domino effect impacting even our local weather. So what is the transition to neutral? Well, we're expecting to actually say goodbye to La Niña sometime during February through April. In fact, according to NOAA, there's actually an 82% chance of this actually happening. So what happens heading into spring and into summer? We likely will be in somewhat of a neutral pattern, which typically means it's only a matter of time before we make that transition into the El Nino climate pattern, which drastically impacts our local pattern as well. So in orange, you'll see the probabilities that we start to see that El Nino pattern emerge, and we'll likely start to see that sometime during spring, and then that could actually take over into summer. And if you know what summer brings, you know that it's the rainy season, but it also kicks off the start of hurricane season for the Atlantic Basin only. Typically during an El Nino, we tend to see fewer hurricanes. So that's one of those impacts. The other thing we have to pay attention though to, if El Nino continues through even this upcoming winter, we typically see more cold fronts. So during the La Niña, we've been looking at fewer cold fronts. And when those cold fronts come in, they're typically less stormy, bringing less of a severe weather threat. You can picture the opposite for El Niños.